In this video, we will be covering important tips when investigating the acidity of beverages. This experiment is Lab 4 from Vernier Chemistry Investigations for use with AP Chemistry Lab Book and correlates to Lab 4 from the College Board's Lab Manual for AP Chemistry. If you're looking for a video demonstrating acid-base titrations, visit our video training library available under the Training tab on our website. This investigation builds on the understanding of an acid-base titration learned in first-year chemistry courses. The goal of this investigation is to determine the concentration of an acid in the beverage that may be a sports beverage, fruit juice, or soft drink. You may also be able to identify the acid. There are some additional challenges that need to be considered when titrating beverages. Here are some points to consider. Soft drinks and fruit juices can contain more than one acid. Consider how this will affect the titration when determining the acid concentration. In addition to the acid in soft drinks, carbonation due to carbonic acid can affect the acid concentration. Think about how to account for the carbonation. Is the acid in the beverage a monoprotic, diprotic, or triprotic acid? Will this affect the calculation of the acid concentration? Will any ingredients in the beverages, such as food dyes, affect the titration data? For the equipment, here are two options for setting up the titration. Either option can be used with the computer running Logger Pro software or with LabQuest. This setup here uses your burette and a pH sensor. The volume will be manually entered for each pH reading. The setup here uses a Vernier drop counter and pH sensor. The drop counter will automatically record the volume at each pH reading. If the investigation includes identifying the acid in the beverage, calibrating the pH sensor along with calibrating the burette or drop counter are important. Instructions for calibrating the pH sensor are in the user guide and available in our tech info library. The default calibration for the drop counter is 28 drops per milliliter, and instructions for calibrating the drop counter are available in the user manual and will be briefly described. The first step is to access the calibration option for the drop counter in your data collection program. In Logger Pro, choose Experiment, then choose Calibrate, and choose Drop Counter, and follow the instructions on the screen. Then if you want to calibrate in LabQuest, tap on Sensors, choose Calibrate, and choose Drop Counter. The rate when you're calibrating should be no faster than approximately one drop for every 2 seconds into the graduated cylinder. So I've readjusted the setup here now to calibrate the drop counter using a 10 milliliter graduated cylinder and making sure again the drop rate is no faster than approximately one drop for every 1 to 2 seconds. The intent is to collect approximately 9 to 10 milliliters of liquid in the graduated cylinder, and the software calculates the drops per mil based on the number of drops counted and the manually entered volume. The calibration corresponds to the reagent reservoir. Be sure to use the same reagent reservoir for the calibration and for the investigation. Once the investigation is completed, this graph is representative of an acid-base titration. The sample data was collected using Gatorade. If you're looking for a video demonstrating the techniques and steps of an acid-base titration, visit our website and check out the video training library under the Training tab. For more information about our lab book, Vernier Chemistry Investigations for use with AP Chemistry, visit our website.